Welcome back, friends, to the Savvy Campers. Today, we're going to share with you 15 tips to keep you warmer in your travel trailer, RV, camper, tent trailer this year. So stay tuned. Before we get started, let me tell you about the Savvy Campers. We have a website and we have a full YouTube channel that has how-tos. We have a lot of informational. We have best of. We share a lot of information with you guys. We buy things, we test it, and we share what works and what doesn't. Anyways, let's get started with our 15 tips. So the first tip to keep you warmer in your RV, camper, travel trailer this year is to use an electric heater. And whenever we're plugged into 110, we bring this little guy around and we have a 21 footer, and this does a great job of keeping us heated. It's got temperature controls. Make sure you don't just get one with medium, high, low, medium, because then you'll fry yourself out if you leave it on at night. This one, you can set it. It's got plus, minus, and you can see on the digital display. So you can set it for 71 degrees or 70 degrees, 68 degrees, and it'll stay at that temperature and it'll turn on whenever it senses it less. So this is a great addition. So if you are looking for a heater, we'll have our recommendation down in the comments. Remote is handy because if you are in bed and it's a little hot or a little cold, you can just click it up or down. It's also great to, not only when you're sleeping, but to just leave on during the day to keep the RV heated. You only need it in the room that you're currently occupying, so you don't have to run your furnace. You'll save some fuel that way. So that's the number one tip. All right, number two tip to keep heated in your travel trailer this winter or season is by using a heated mattress pad. A heated mattress pad will keep you heated at night when you're sleeping. It'll give you a little extra warmth, and you've got your covers on top and your heated mattress pad on the bottom, and then obviously you're in the middle. So it will create heat and it'll radiate in there and keep you warmer at night. Third item would be to use an electric blanket. An electric blanket will work just like the mattress pad, except for it'll go on top of you. And so whether you get a heated mattress pad or electric blanket, either one will keep you warm. I did find that most electric blankets I found needed 110 volt power. So if you have plug-ins, that's great. But we did find some mattress pads that only used 12 volt power. So you could run those off your battery. So make sure to check those out to see what's compatible with your camping situation. So the fourth tip to keep warm in your travel trailer would be to use your oven to cook, or your range. Let's say you're making soup, throw your range on, that heat will add a little bit of heat to your RV. If you're using your oven, throw a Costco lasagna in there, have it cook for an hour and a half, however long it takes, and it will add some radiant heat to your camper. So it's a good idea to maybe use the slow cooker, use the stove, use the oven when it's colder out, so you'll get some of that heat in your camper. Fifth trick to keeping your travel trailer heated this winter is to position it towards the sun. If you've got a side with a lot of windows, you'll want to have that side be towards the sun so that sunlight can help heat your RV, and you'll want to park in areas that aren't shaded, that are out in the open. And if you do that, it'll also help if you have a solar system keeping you charged so your batteries don't get diminished from using your propane heater too much. The sixth item that we're going to talk about is heat duct placement and the angle of the duct. So in our trailer, we've got a heat duct that literally will blow up and down. It's got louvers to do that, or it'll go side to side and you can tilt it around. And it's funny because up and down, you're blowing at the ground and straight up, whereas if you go like this, I've got a wall right here, so I'm blowing straight at the wall, and then this is the only little bit that is going into the travel trailer. So what I've done is I found a different type of louver that only blows this way, so I change the louver out so it blows all of the air towards the front of the trailer to get as much airflow as possible. So always watch which angle your louvers are facing and make sure they're all open. And then make sure the placement of your heat ducts is in good spots. And we'll talk about in the next hint to move your heat ducts. In addition to your heat duct placement and angle, make sure that a heat duct is not pushing right out towards your thermostat. In our RV, our one heat duct in our main cabin literally pushes straight out towards our thermostat. So what we've had to do is take that thermostat and move it on a different wall, because basically it would get heated in this area right here, but then towards the front of the trailer, it just would not get heated. So we had to move that thermostat. We didn't move it quite all the way to the front because we didn't want the back of the trailer to fry, but we moved it 4 or 5 feet forward just so that we get good air circulation, so we're not prematurely causing our heater to turn on and off too often. The seventh item, and we do have a full video on how we did this, is by adding a heat duct. So our, like I said, our trailer only has a heat duct in the bathroom, which is at the far rear, and then we had a heat duct right at the fridge, which is right outside of the bathroom. And then the whole front of the cabin with the bed and couch has no heat duct. So what we've done is we've taken a heat duct and extended it to go up to the bed area. So when we do have our heat on, it will get the front of the RV warm. It doesn't shoot too much, which we didn't want a lot of heat there because when we sleep, we like it colder anyways. But it's enough to actually have some airflow, which there virtually was no airflow from the factory. So tip number 8 would be to wear proper clothing. If you know you're gonna be in the cold, bring some long underwear, bring some sweatshirts, make sure you have good clothing, make sure you layer up for the winter and when you're in your travel trailer so you don't have to run your heat all the time. Maybe you could leave your thermostat set at 65 or 66 instead of 70, but layer up so you don't blow through all your propane at the beginning of your trip. So the ninth tip we have is when you're sleeping, use a sleeping bag. It'll help keep you warm at night so you can save your propane by not heating your RV too hot, and it'll keep you warm through the night and you'll be all layered up and comfortable. So that is a good hint that we use in the colder season. Yes, we have a bed with sheets, and that's one of the reasons why we bought a travel trailer, but it's also nice not to blow through all your battery and propane at the beginning of your trip when you're boondocking. So we bring sleeping bags just so we can stay warm at night so we don't have to use a bunch of heat. All right, so we are to tip number 10. You may notice in your travel trailer that there's lots of areas that have air leaks and aren't really well insulated. So we have an area under our couch where we have, if you pull our couch out, you can see the wheel well, and it's a metal wheel well, but then around the wheel well, there's no insulation. So basically you have fresh air, so when it's cold out, just blowing up through those cracks. So what we've done is we've taken some spray foam and sealed up those air gaps. And we've also done that not only on the wheel wells, but we've gone around the trailer and really felt for what sections are colder. And we've looked to see, okay, why is it colder? Oh, there's no insulation, or there's an air gap around the water inlet pipe or around the outside shower, and we've gone through and sealed up some of that just so those air leaks are gone. So item number 11, along with having those metal wheel wells, is it's metal, so it's uninsulated. So we've gone through and we've got a lot of this closed cell insulation. We use some 1-inch, and I did use some 2-inch, but I don't know, on a travel trailer when you're using it very little, is it worth the money? I don't know. But we've gone through and added this to a lot of spots on our RV. Our front pass-through storage, basically our bed is above that, and our bed kind of gets cold, so we've added this around it. And make sure to use tape to seal your seams just so you don't have air gaps between that. And you can also use some spray foam in conjunction with that to insulate it. Another thing to insulate would be your vent covers in the ceiling. Those things literally have no insulation. So I'll have a link in the description for some insulating, basically like a pillow that you can put up there. There's reflective if you want that, or non-reflective, and you throw it up there and it just fits in place. There's no need to install anything, and it'll insulate those vent covers, and that we found helped out a lot. So tip number 12 will only help you if you have a travel trailer, camper, RV, if you're staying in place for a longer period of time. If you're staying for one night, it might not make sense, but skirting your trailer will help out a lot in keeping it warm. And you can use, once again, you can go to Home Depot, Lowe's, buy this one inch insulation, and throw it under there to go from the bottom of the travel trailer to the ground. Or you could get a vinyl skirt that you snap on with buttons, or you can use other things such as plywood or wood. I've seen people use snow, and they pack up snow so it you reduce the airflow and that heat under your camper stays heated. That also helps your pipes keep warm so they don't freeze under there as well. Tip number 13 is also a decorative thing, but if you add curtains and rugs to your windows and floor, it will help out a lot. If you're standing on your floor, which our floor, even though we have a heated underbelly, it gets cold. And when you're standing on there with bare feet or socks at night, it's cold. But maybe put some rugs, like we have one in the bathroom and we have one at our kitchen, just so our feet can stay warm when we're cooking or when we're coming out of the shower or when we're going to the bathroom or brushing our teeth. Our feet stay much warmer with that extra layer from the rug. And then curtains, when you close them, they'll also provide some sort of insulation value to keep, most windows are just single pane in RVs. So there's, ours get cold, our metal gets cold around the windows. So curtains can help out a lot as well. All right, now we're getting to a couple tips that are more things that you can do. So number 14 would be exercise in your RV. Do some push-ups, do some sit-ups, some jumping jacks, get your blood flowing, and it'll keep you a little bit warmer. And we all know that we get warm when we work out, so just every half an hour, every hour, do some jumping jacks, push-ups, sit-ups, whatever you need to do, burpees, lunges, and you'll stay a little bit warmer. You've got your blood flowing, and you could keep warmer and keep that thermostat down so you can save your energy so you don't run out of propane in the middle of the night. Tip number 15 would be to drink a warm beverage. Have a warm coffee, have a cup of tea, have something warm so your insides get warm and it'll keep you warmer inside. We love sipping on warm coffee or tea in winter or spring or summer, or excuse me, late fall. And it just keeps us warm inside. So that is the 15th tip. All right, now that we've shared our 15 tips with you, it's time to go. So hopefully you implement one of them, if not more than one, to help you stay more comfortable with your winter camping, your spring camping, your fall camping, and even in the summer, you might have some early morning, late nights that dip into the low temperatures depending on where you're at. So anyways, happy trails, and we'll see you at the campground.